Thank you. Thank you. Goes far. is a matter of love's desire, magical ladies without its squires, magical ladies, without its squires.
Home with my parents, and have been led here.
My soul is dangerous car. That dotard Dr. Basil won't let it onto anyone. That's why she left the window.
Oh, how awful! My dear is raging. What a impulse me, I have conceived. I must speak to her. You want to help me out?
My, what passion! All right, I'll lend a hand.
Now, bravo! Warwell have introduced me to this household. Tell me, how could you do it? With your ability, we'll see a great production.
My ability? Gladly. Let's see, there's just one thing.
Oh, now I hear you. Come on and do my doubt. All of your labor, large compensation is coming.
It is.
I promise.
Then you'll pay me a handsome fee.
Go by the bushels. Thank you, and onward.
I'm ready. Why, it's amazing how the mention of money by a servant, Signorino, promotes my inspiration and stirs my brain to keen imagination. At the thought of precious metal, so impressive in valuation.
A botanic inspiration. Sounds commencing in my mind.
Yes!
This invention,
Sir. that old coat.
Thank you.
what is it? Why so glum?
I am in the doldrums.
Ridiculous, impossible. A girl so charming, so pretty, so full of spirit.
You're making fun of me. What good does it do for me? What good is being witty with nothing but these walls for an audience? I sometimes would rather be dead
than buried. Be dead and buried? Oh, goodness, now listen. I have news for you.
I hear some steps.
Who is it?
It's not mortal. I can tell.
Then I'm off. But once that goat has left you, I must speak to you in private.
And so must I, Signor Vivo.
We'll talk again later.
He's delightful.
Now, isn't she a darling? He hates me, but I adore a little rascal. I am certain it is the barber who has turned her against me. Who knows what he has told her? I will find out. Hey, Bertha! Bertha, just...
What?
You falter.
Tell me, hasn't a barber been talking to Rosina? Can't you speak? You heard me. Stop that yawning. I said stop it.
I'm tired.
Ah, speak up.
Yes, sir. He talks.
Rosina. Why, those morons. They are half dead, stupid, and lazy. Be off now.
It Oh, won't you?
Secret whispers that are sliding, that are sliding all around us, all around us, in the ears of all the people. Introducing us discreetly in their brains' imagination, in their brains' imagination. What will stun them and will daze them and will spread like a disease? From their lips an innuendo, and their stalking in crescendo, gaining force by little traces, flying out to different places, so we wonder at the tempest from the heart of every heart.
A wizard of a doctor, married the girl of her money.
that. You wait, we'll teach you a lesson. While they're plotting and scheming, I must find Rosie and warn her. Ah, signorina.
What news, Signor Pino?
It's serious, Rosina.
Yes, you mean it.
We'll be having a party.
What's that supposed to mean?
It's very simple. By tomorrow evening, your worthy guardian has arranged to become your unworthy husband.
You're joking.
Oh, no, I'm serious. Here in the doctor's study, he himself and Basilio are drawing up the contract.
What? How dumb they must be, those two blockheads. They have to deal with me. Now tell me, Senor Fido, some time ago under my bedroom window, you were talking to someone.
Oh, that was my cousin, a promising young fellow. He has talent and a heart of gold. He's living in Sevilla as a student. And the poor boy hopes he'll make his fortune.
It's fortune that he will do.
Oh, I'm not quite so certain. And to be truthful, he has a dreadful defect.
He has a defect?
Yes, dreadful. He's head over heels in love.
Don't you believe
me? Oh, thank you.
And his beloved, tell me, is she at a distance?
Oh, no, she lives near, 2 paces.
Is she pretty?
Oh, she's a beauty. Here's a brief description of what she looks like. Her figure, like Venus, her hair is velvet. She's like 2 roses, eyes that simply sparkle, peach-like complexion.
And her name is?
I have forgotten. One moment now. What is it her name is?
Well, then, her name is?
Olivia. I'll spell it. Just a line of your approval that you'll be
don't be bashful.
No, I should not.
It's so easy.
It is shameful.
Why on earth? Tell me why. Say why. Waste no time and write the letter.
Thank you. Oh, See for yourself, see for shirts. I mean a quadri, she's a right there. That's an adorary.
Yes, it did. happens I lodge in a vein where the crown stays, and by some chance I came into possession of this little letter that Rosina has sent to him. See for yourself.
Rosina, it is her writing.
And Don Basilio does not know that I have it, and since I came here to give the girl her lesson in his place, I am most anxious to make your approval, because this little message remains.
For what?
I'll explain it. If I could for a moment speak to Rosina,
ah.
I'd tell her that I saw it in the hands of a certain lady that is his mistress, thus rousing a suspicion that found me trace Rosina with his mistress. In this case.
Just a moment. That would be slander. How clever! I see you are a student of Don Basilio. You are right. I appreciate what you have done, and you will find me grateful. I will let you see Rosina. I will call her this minute. You are a very helpful. You are a friend indeed.
No! Do not doubt it. A fable of the letter came out of my mouth. Have chased me away like any bad one. But now that she'll see her, and it should go well. She has said my heart will know no measure. And there she is, my heart all unleaves with pleasure.
Come, come, Rosina, don't be bashful. Mr. Don Alonso, today he
China.
Oh, what do I know that you worry? An idea.
bottom I was knocking and stumbled on a key I could hold on to.
Ah.
I could not see my hands in front of my face. In the darkness, I almost broke my neck when I slipped. Why can't they leave a light on? Moreover, moreover.
All right, all right.
Can we start?
Careful.
I'm ready.
Yes, sir.
Yes, we did.
Get down from my house, come before I go raise.
that case, he's a spy for the count. Some enormous deceit is in the making.
And I say this Don Alonso is none other than the count.
You think a soul?
I know a soul. His money said so clearly.
Listen, Don Alonso, go and get the lawyer. Here is the key to my front door. See that you hurry. All is at stake.
Don't you worry. In a flash, I shall be back.
This evening we shall be married, for my name's not Don Alonso.
I just got an idea. If with the letter Rosina wrote today to Count Alma Viva, I could convince her, what a stroke of genius. I will show you, Don Alonso, how I will use the letter you have brought me.
Hey, Rosina, Martin, come quickly. I want to show you some important information. I will show you. Oh, how could you be so foolish? You have wasted your love upon an impostor. He who pretends to love you is trying to trick you. He loves another woman. Ah, here is the proof.
Oh, heavens, this is my letter.
But Alonso and the barber are trying to trick you and to betray you. They want to buy you for their master, the Count Alma Viva.
In the arms of another, I can't do that. Oh, in Doro, you have betrayed me. Oh, yes, and vengeance will teach you. You are heartless, who Rosina is. Tell me, Signore, do you still wish to become my husband?
Yes. I'm ready.
Well then, so be it. I now am contented, but right away. Now listen, tonight at midnight, that traitor will come here with me to all the world, to flee with him and marry him, I have intended.
Stay in your room and nothing, and I'll call the police. I'll tell them they are schemers, that they should be punished. Leave it to me. We'll put them all in prison. Now, dear, do as I ask. I must be going.
Thank you.
sir, we have arrived.
Eagle, lend a hand. That was some weather. It only fits for battles.
And also for eloping lovers.
Here, praise your lantern. Where's my dear Rosina?
She must be waiting. Ah, here she is.
My darling.
Oh, wait, I do not want to see you. The only reason why I'm here is to reject you, to tell you what I think of you, and to express my contempt, so that you know that you've lost me, faithless deceiver, shameless pretender.
This is a nightmare.
I am absolutely speechless.
But it is wrong.
Traitor! You want to sell me, pretending that you love me, to your vile little master called Paul of Evil.
Oh, darling, blessed deception, oh, happy moment, love was only motive, I'm no longer in dolor. Oh, I'm
shall we through?
What is the matter?
The ladder!
Well, what?
It is no longer there.
The ladder!
But who could have removed it?
Someone tricked us. We're trapped.
Oh, how disastrous!
One moment, I see people. We are discovered. I'm afraid it looks bad.
Here, Rosina, I'll protect you.
Let them come in.
Don Bartolo! Don Bartolo!
It was you. Who's with him?
My mind, he came with a notary. What could be better? I'll carry on from here. How do you do, sir? As you know, I have summoned you this evening to my house to perform the marriage between Count Abadina and a young lady. The couple happens to be here. I hope you brought the papers with you. That's excellent.
One moment. Don Bartolo is not here.
Hey, no mercy, no. He is a diamond for your troubles.
Beg pardon.
Or else, if you prefer, put it through your forehead. One or the other.
I see. I'll take the diamond to your servant.
Now we can sign it. You will be one witness, Figaro will be the other.
On to the signing.
We've done it!
Oh, happy ending to my grief!
We've done it!
Oh, animals, stay where you are!
Give me time to explain!
At last we've caught them! Do your duty and arrest them!
Will the gentleman give his name?
I'm Count Abadina in person!
I see now. Clearly, I was a fool.
Yes, that is so.
And you scoundrel, your people, you acted as a witness.
Oh, what else could I do? I could not help it. The Count carries in his pocket certain devices which left me no alternative.
And I, stupid idiot, I helped them to get married by removing the ladder from the balcony. Ah!